Good morning. This is Mike Neundorfer at Advanced RV in Cleveland, Ohio, and I'm going to talk a little bit this morning about macerators. At Advanced RV, one of our objectives, one of the things we're working long-term for, is absolute zero defects. In order to do this, we have to document every issue that requires maintenance or service. We not only have to document what the issues are, but we have to try to find the root cause and then correct the root cause of the issue. Advanced RV can do this because we're involved with every issue that comes up. Before shipment, obviously, we're involved. We spend about a week after we build a motorhome doing functional and other inspections, but also for our rental units and for our client motorhomes, we're involved with every repair, whether we do it here in our facility or whether we support other organizations across the country repairing any issue that comes up with an Advanced RV. So I thought I'd share with you this morning a few of the things with a macerator that we found that have caused failures. But before we do that, let's talk a little bit about why we use a macerator. The macerator is a combination of a grinder and a pump. There are four little blades on a rotor here that grind up the waste and then pump it. So one of the beauties of a macerator is that it is a pump and it will pump up to 15 vertical feet, so you're not relying on gravity to empty the tanks as you do with a 3-inch gravity drain. The other thing about a macerator is that it stays connected to the 1-inch discharge hose. So all we do is pull out the discharge hose, put it in the sewer, quarter turn the valve on, initiate the operation of the macerator, and open the gates. One thing that we do in addition to trying to eliminate issues, maintenance issues through design and through root cause understanding, is we try to make everything accessible for maintenance. So the macerator, as you can see that we use, hooks onto a bayonet mount. Its wiring and hose are such that you can actually turn the macerator, pull it back away from the connection, and either remove it for replacement or hook up a gravity 3-inch pipe as a backup. Macerators are great, but they do fail sometimes. Why do they fail? Well, one of the things that causes failure is if you turn on the macerator, empty the tank, and then continue to run the macerator without any fluid going through it. Running a macerator for extended periods dry will burn up the motor or blow a fuse. Another thing that we found, and these are things that we won't talk about the causes for, but we've taken macerators off that have failed and found they were gunked up with paper towels. So paper towels in the toilet mess up your motorhome sewer just like they do at home. Another thing we found that's caused a macerator problem is a stone. Don't ask us how it got there, but a stone in the macerator will jam the rotor and burn up the macerator motor. We've also found fabric, and again, don't ask, but we found fabric. It looks like shredded parts of rugs or whatever, and those will clog up the macerator and cause it to fail. So these are four things that we know will cause a macerator to fail. We found most of them through our rental units, and we've increased our training a little bit to tell people no stones in the toilet and other things. In summary, we use macerators because they pump uphill, because you can leave the hose connected to the macerator and just pull it out. Hose storage is easier and you can get more length of hose with a 1-inch hose than you can with a 3-inch hose. We would love to eliminate the possibility of the macerator failing for any reason. The reasons that we found that macerators fail are usually user mistakes or user abuse. We're going to continue to work on improving our macerator design and our system design. So hope you enjoyed this, hope you found it helpful, and thanks for watching.